Hi, I'm Boaz Lerner, the head of the data science track in the Department of Industrial Engineering and Management. And Mark's request to give the talk in English came after the slides were already prepared, so I speak in English, but the slides are in Hebrew. The Industrial Engineering and Management Department, or IEM for short, was established in 1969 and is the leading and the largest IEM department in Israel. Is one of the two largest departments in the Faculty of Engineering Sciences and one of the largest departments in the university. We have 35 faculty members, over 1,000 students in all degrees, almost 900 in the first degree, 130 master students and 45 PhDs, and 14 active research labs. Our research and teaching activities are very diverse. Beside data science, we have tracks in intelligence systems, information systems, operation research, human factors, robotics, and statistics. Since its inception, IEM put large emphasis on quantitative research and teaching, especially in statistics, operation research, and information system. In 2010, we started delivering courses in machine learning and data mining and supervised theses. The first were completed in 2009. 2013, we offered concentration in data science and business analytics. And since then, 41 students have graduated with theses and another six without theses. In 2018, we offer the track in data science together with the information and software engineering systems, where we currently have 34 students enrolled and another 17 in an independent statistic track. With respect to the courses that Leo mentioned, that Malag defined, so we deliver 14 courses in the core fields of data science and another 11 in the secondary non-core fields. The research IEM is very disciplinary, both internally among faculty members, but also externally. And we cover actually all core fields of the Malag. So in each of the core fields, we have at least one researcher. These are machine learning, deep learning, data analysis and computer vision, statistics, data analysis and visualization, experiment design, sampling and inference, information systems, databases and big data, distributed computations, among other. And also in the secondary non-core fields defined by Malag, we have at least one researcher in each one of them, in artificial intelligence, optimization, operation research, robotics, game theory, stochastic processes, information theory, control, signal processing, public health and epidemiology, digital health and personal medicine and cybersecurity. We enjoyed budget from several organizations and offices, for example, the European Committee, the European Union, the ISF, ministries, Israeli ministries like the agriculture, the science and technology, and the economic and trade offices. Also found from road safety authority or IAROC organization. And we have fruitful cooperations with major players in the high-tech industry like Intel, IBM, Dell, and Microsoft, and also from organizations like Volcani Center, medical centers like Soroka, Ichilov, Bellinson, Kaplan Hospital, and also armies, the Israeli and the Americans, among others. Examples for research project at IEM. So first we conduct and undertake studies in a theoretical and algorithmical aspects of data science. For example, in learning models, latent variable models, temporal models, graphical models, deep learning, both for practical missions like detection and classification, but also to understand how they operate. We study new paradigms of classification and clustering, including performance measures to evaluate them. We study mobility patterns and their relation to social life. Also in process control and concept-driven detection and the impact of missing data on the results or the performance of classifiers and how to impute data. We do research in information systems, for example, data infrastructures, how to protect data and organizational resources from cyber attacks, human-computer interface and visualization, and human behavior in the net. We also have research in medicine and public health, for example, for the analysis, prediction, stratification, and diagnosis of diseases, visual identification of medicines, false alarm reduction in intensive care units, brain imaging. In transportation and road safety, we are interested in predicting accident severity, to analyze the involvement of young drivers in accidents, and how to optimally deploy traffic lights. We have research in robotics and interfaces, for example, to analyze human movement, rehabilitation using robots, robotic assembly. We also have studies in agricultural and environment, for example, identifying factors affecting yield, detecting blossom or flowering peak, growth rate, social land identification of in urban areas. And let me give you maybe two examples of research that we've been doing these days. The first is a consortium funded by the Innovation Authority. We have three faculty members that are involved in this project, in which we get images of crops from the field, the greenhouse, plantation, where we are interested in making agriculture preciser and more efficient, for example, by detecting fruits, by tackling occlusion among fruits in order to improve detection, to detect and count leaves, to detect the flowering peak of, for example, here, apple flowers, and to early detect stresses and diseases in plants. The second project is in precision medicine. Here we are interested in a neurodegenerative disease, for example, in stratifying the heterogeneous population into smaller homogeneous subgroups of patients. So here, for example, but you can see, let's say, at the bottom left plot, you can see progression rate of patients stratified to four groups with respect to their bulbar functionality, bulbar, which means speech, swallowing, salivation, compared to their functionality in the in their upper limbs, for example, handwriting and cutting food. And you can see that there is one group, the red one, of patients with almost no deterioration, whereas the blue or the cyan group is of patients with large deterioration levels. And there are two other groups, the green and the magenta groups, that probably have the same progression rate, total progression rate, but there are different patient groups. One is with higher deterioration in their bulbar functionality, the other in their limb functionality, which is very important when you try to plan treatment to patients or to develop drugs. If we look into these groups, so here we have six rather than four groups, you can see that, for example, group number one, the patients have almost no progression of the disease. Group two have linear but very slow progression. Number three have moderate but still linear progression. And groups four, five, and six show different non-linear progression patterns. Then we can use the data to induce, for example, predictors that can predict functionality, for example, in 250, 400, or 500 days ahead. The red dots are the actual functionality levels. The black solid line is our prediction. And here you can see three different patients where prediction was quite accurate from day one, from the first visit. And here you can see another patient that his prediction of functionality was very poor in the beginning, but as more data for more clinic visit arrived, prediction improved. So thank you very much for listening, and if you have any question, I'd be happy to answer.